Hey, it's Coolio if you don't know, and today we're playing Milon's Secret Castle for the Game Boy. I've already played this for the Nintendo on my own channel, CoolioMZX, but Jason a while ago has asked the group members to do a thing. But first, here's a story, and I've only learned about this cutscene about 5 minutes ago. Oh no, the princess has been taken away by some kind of bat-looking thing, or something, I don't know. But here is Milon to save the day, after learning how to music and such. I don't remember the story exactly, but that's approximately it. So yeah, that probably is going to play a couple more times while I'm doing my explanation here. A while ago, Jason came to the group and asked us all to play a game that would probably be done in about 1 to 2 hours, and that we would have fun playing. Now, the NES version of Milon's Secret Castle is kind of a pain, but this version is entirely a lot better than that version. I just played it end-to-end a couple of days ago, just for myself, and decided, well, this might be a fun project, so let's get started. Alright. Let me just readjust the volume here. Sorry. This is such a professional grade video type thing. Now this is going to be pretty much as close to a 100% run that I can do. And also the controls are a bit weird, but I'll deal with it. So we're Milon. We can shoot bubbles, as you can see. Right now we can only shoot one bubble, but that will change. When I collect this, if I collect this, there we go. Now, for the moment, we can shoot two bubbles. But if we get hit, that will go back down to one. Every honeycomb you collect will add 1 point to your maximum health. There are about 8 or 9 throughout the game, and I'll find as many as I can. Okay, so I guess one hit is not going to be enough to knock our bubble production down to one. Now right now I'm just kind of running around, sometimes busting walls and finding money, sometimes busting faces and finding umbrellas. But then there's this door. Now this door is currently locked. We need a key. Where can we find a key? By killing one of these last enemies, we heard a little sound. So if we go down here, a key has appeared. Pretty much the idea is to kill a whole bunch of things, destroy a whole bunch of blocks, and eventually a key will appear, which will allow you to exit by the normal exit. But there are a couple of things that we need to find. Well, no, need to, but, well, one of them we need to. This one here. You push this last hole through the hole that I created, I guess, and we get a little shop where we can buy this. Jump high, you're at Set Springs. There are also a couple of hidden secret entrance in front wall, and bump head to find box. Bump head to find box, huh? Wonder how that works. Oh, there it is. Music box. This will lead to a bonus stage! I know just about where all the bonus stages are, so I should be able to show you all of those. Right now we only have Little Drummer Boy at the middle there at the top with an instrument, but the more music boxes we find, the more instruments will be in the song. Music notes are worth 1 note, sharps are worth 2 notes, and flats are worth -1. Once the music ends, which it's about to, we'll get $1 per note we've collected, as you can see. But if we can manage to collect 50 notes or more, then that goes down to $1 for every 2 notes collected, thus increasing your bonus by that much. That's about it for this level. There is one more thing that I can possibly find, but they changed where it's located in this Game Boy version, and I don't know where it is. We'll likely see it sometime in the game, so I'm not worried. Now it is nighttime. There are lightning bolts afoot. Just a matter of avoiding those. One of the few flaws in the Game Boy version of this game is it is kind of hard to enter the outside doors sometimes. So, now that we got the boots, spring shoes as one might call them, I don't know the exact name, but anyway. Whenever we see a platform, we can bounce off it. There's another hidden shop here, which contains this. Shrink when you touch the glove. Now that's nothing, and if we need health, we can hit this one. But we're at full health, so we're not gonna worry about it. The key has been activated. And there's the honeycomb. I think there's anything else in here. And the key is going to be over here. Now there's something in there. There we go. Open it up from the top there. Get some extra money. Every cent counts. Now I'm not going to be able to, probably not going to be able to get the, oh yeah, there we go. And off to the bonus stage! Now I think we've got, yeah, dude number 6 there at the top has cymbals now. So that doesn't really change the song a whole lot, it's still entirely percussion, but, it'll get better. And I promise to just let the music play and speak for itself when we get up to the last one. I'm trying not to hum along because I know what the song is and it's quite pleasant. But you're gonna just have to wait for it. Na 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 na. Unfortunately, that is going to bump us back to the beginning, but I made sure to collect the key before getting into the music box. There's no thing there yet. Yeah, collected the key before going into the music box, so we have that, we don't have to worry about it. The door is there, but there is another hidden shop on this level. And we need to have gotten the potion here because we need to shrink. I said we need to shrink. Thank you. Whole bunch of hidden money here. And shop is here. We can get that now, but there is actually another place in the game where you can get that for a lot cheaper. So I'm gonna save my $40, thank you. Secrets in the well. Hmm. Interesting. We can use this to escape. Ow. You jerk. Yeah. Now we're going to go into the middle door here. There's got to be another shop. I think we could have gotten the potion to shrink down from here, but it would have been a lot more than only $4. Let's check the hints. Find a saw. Good advice. And Crystal has miracle power. But where can we find a crystal? Well, there's only one place we haven't checked. In here. Oh no, it's the boss! They made bosses a lot easier in the Game Boy version. For one thing, I think they take fewer hits, and secondly, you can hit them anywhere, whereas the NES version, you had to hit them in the face. So with all that completed, we're on to the second floor. And here's another improvement for the Game Boy version. More than, like, two songs. Get that! Get that! Yes! The Hudson Bee will appear if you shoot a specific location in the level, which will give us some extra shielding. You can collect hearts as well to increase that shielding. Now this level has one of those, there's the exit door. Urgh! I don't want to lose my shield yet. I'd rather not lose it at all, but I mean, if I had a choice. Yeah, let's see what's in here. Aha! Helps you in the fire room. Yes, that is the flame-resistant vest. We'll see more about that later. The vest lets in heat. What this is telling us is eventually there will be fire, and the vest will help us resist the heat, but it's not going to make us immune to it. We can still take damage. Whenever you can shrink down, do so. I mean, it just gives you a smaller hitbox for one thing, lets you get into sneakier places, and really has no disadvantages. Bonus number 3. Ah, got a little more here. We got the tuba there up in number 7. Ah. Now my test run, I actually didn't get any really good bonuses. I wasn't able to get to break 50 at any point. Pretty consistently break 40, but that's about it. This time, however, make it to 39. Oh well, still very good. Ah! I'd really like to get a heart. Damn it. There you go. Ah! No! I lost my shield! A fair amount about this game, but I'm not, like, a master at it, so I'm not gonna know everything right, you know, like the back of my hand here. Oh, that's where we came in, right. Ah, this level. This one's a bit of an annoying one. Another kind of disadvantage with this port of the game. It gets very laggy. It's really, like, not optimized at all. Okay, where is the... Hey, music box. Around here. That's where the exit door is. There it is. Let's get some more money. Bonus number 4. Now let's see which one. Number 5 up there has an ocarina. It's starting to sound more like music, isn't it? I do actually have a physical copy of this game, which I picked up at a secondhand store over in Moncton, New Brunswick. Really nice store. It's one of the few things that I miss about actually living in that city. 30. Wow, that's poor. Game says very good, but I know better. I can do better than that. Pretty much every one of these sublevels has a store in it, so always be on the lookout. I believe that the one in this level is that little indent right below me. Ow! Jerk! I'm gonna try to get rid of these evenly. And exit through here. Also exit through here, but that's going backward now. There's a key right above us. That is a spring lock. Is there a dollar there? No. However, this is where the shop is. And as you can see, we get the lantern here at $14 rather than $40. Big advantage. The well is climbable, and a balloon makes bigger bubble. Okay. I'll take your word for that. Hudson B. Yes. The advantage of the game being laggy, the Hudson B takes its sweet bippin' time. Yes, please. More health is always good. Get that heart. Get that key. Alright. I do believe that we have everything out of this floor. Want that. Getting more umbrellas is always a good thing. If at any point your shot count is maxed, getting an umbrella will actually increase your health. Alright, here is the fabled well. And it's really hard to get past this first part. Actually, no, not that hard. Just gotta think about it differently. There we go. And, oh yeah, that's another thing. Now that we have enough umbrellas, we have rapid fire. Dang it. There we go. Okay, I do believe that there is a honeycomb somewhere in this this area. I know that there is not. There it is. There is not a music box in this area. Alright. For some reason, the wall contains fire. This is beyond me why this is the case, but yep, the well is fiery. Oh jeez. Hi. Not super familiar with the layout of the well. Ow! Bollocks. Okay. We are out of shield. Pretty sure there's a Hudson Beast somewhere in here, too. Come on, where's the opening? Okay. I can't do anything about this guy. Just gonna have to run through, make our way to our next boss. Which looks like, something. Leave your interpretations in the comments and try not to make it too dirty. What it's gonna look like in a minute, though, is dead. There we go. We got a couple shots on us, and we did lose a couple of umbrellas, but now we have bigger bubbles. And we get a free hammer. You can enter through the front wall. Now, we could climb the well manually, but that's a pain. Instead, we're going to defeat this guy and grab balloon! It'll just take us right out. Oh jeez. Right out into the storm, apparently. No, I didn't want to go there! Dag nabbit. Okay. Well, that's alright. Since we already have the key for this area, we don't have to go hunting for it again, although we're losing more health than I would like. Ah. Is there anything in here? Yes, now we can actually go through walls in certain places. Dang it! This is not one of those certain places. I rephrase, we can go through walls in uncertain places. This is not the place I'm looking for. There's one in particular where we will get a free saw. All of a sudden our friend, the shopkeeper, I think his name is Barnaby or something like that, is giving us all kinds of free stuff. Now we can enter through windows. I'm also gonna buy some power. Okay, now we're gonna go back up to the second floor, and there's a couple of places up here, oh jeez, that we can go, like here. Nothing in there though, but I believe this one has boss number three, which is some sort of alfalfa pterodactyl or something. Unfortunately, we have We appear to be completely out of umbrellas, so we have one shot. This could take us a while. Maybe, perhaps. Hey, this is an interesting, never thought of this. If you just take a risk and get in there, they can barely touch you. Okay, here we are on floor number 3. I'm gonna take this path here, which is actually gonna take us back down to the first floor. This is actually the first level we were in, but the top left corner of that area where we can get some money. And also, I'm gonna get high power now. And I'm not really worried about the fact that we don't have enough money now for the other set of shoes that we can get. And you'll see why. Check this. Forget if there's something here. Nope. Just enough for us to get trapped by those stupid lightning bolts. This is actually really hard to get to in the NES version. I'm glad that they made it a lot easier. And also, as you can see, the money has regenerated. But I'm still not gonna get the shoes just yet. Because we're gonna do it again! And up. Alright, you can do this 3 times, by the way. If I come back here, there's going to be no more money there. I'm gonna get these. Jump high anytime, anywhere, except on the main map menu here. On the world map, castle map, whatever you want to call it. But as you can see, we have super jump. Pretty much bending to our will at this point. Alright, so we're gonna be here in the third floor for reals this time. Can't go through here. We can go through here. Ooh, want that. Alright, I have heard the sound that means the key has appeared, but we're not going to worry about that yet, because the music box is right here. I'm going to do that first. Bonus number 5. It's really starting to sound like something now that our elf number 2 has a harp. Anyway, it doesn't matter. Doesn't matter what order you do this in. The musicians will always receive their musical instruments in the same order. That should not have been a difficult sentence, but it was. So, but that was excellent. I'll say. It just took us destroying one more enemy to make the key appear again. We're just going to explore these pillars here. Try and get all the money. Also, that is the exit door up in the corner there. Mistaken, yes, there is a door right there. Which has, oh man, really? Which has the sword that we're $1 shy of. Watch out for fake princess. Good advice. Ow. Eh. Okay. Now we have the key for really real Z reels. Like we can go through there. Now we could just easily leave the level now. But we're still missing one thing. I'm not getting that. Well, we're missing two things, technically. We now have enough money to actually get the sword, so I'm gonna do that. The sword is completely, optional, by the way. This is not something that you need to get. Just something that makes life easier, especially when dealing with bosses and mini-bosses. And later on, with the main boss, Maharito. Why can't I break through this wall? It's like I'm just barely missing the actual block I need to hit. Maybe this is the wrong block altogether, I don't know. In any case, maybe I should just keep climbing. Let's actually get this freaking sword. Power up the bubble. Darn right, power up the bubble. I mean, look at it. It's all shiny and stuff. Ow. You get a powered up bubble in the face. That's what you get. Yes, please. Looks like we are at maximum umbrella. Yeah, pardon me if I'm a little sniffly here. Seem to have caught something, but nothing serious. Just a nuisance. Yeah. Okay. I'm definitely overcomplicating this. Ideally, you would go in from the top and climb down. But we kind of came in at a weird angle here, so... Gotta do our best with what we got. Ah. There we go. We're almost there. And then we fall back down to the bottom and land on a thing that probably costs us some umbrella power. Yeah, normally this is where you would come in. And see, this wasn't for nothing. There's some money up here. Every bit of money that we can get will help. Wouldn't it be nice if we could just find money in walls? Just bust walls open. Hey, here's 50 bucks. I'm sure that that a story like this has happened at least once. However, this does not mean that you get to go around busting walls and hoping there's money inside, because chances are there isn't. There it is. Need to get the thing. Okay, there we go. No. I do have a terrible memory, so I'm just being thorough here, making sure I'm not missing anything. Cause I don't want to miss a thing. Okay. So yeah, we have gotten everything that there is to get, I do believe. Now it's just a matter of getting out to the exit. There it is. Bit lagging. That was a bit long, but we made it through. What's in here? Oh. Drop back to second floor, I guess. Fortunately, bosses do not respawn. Yeah. Okay. I think I've designated where I want to go next, which is here. Yeah. No. Get out. Now this level is kind of tricky. Not gonna lie, it's kind of tricky, and that's why there are a lot of hidden pitfalls all over the level. Trying to remember where the music box is. I think it's on that yeah, there it is. No! Wanna get the key first. There we go. Now, music box. Bonus number 6. There we go. Now the song is almost complete. Number 3 has his trumpet. I don't know if these guys have names. I'm just naming them by their position up there. I'm sure that they do have names, but are they ever mentioned? Yes, the song is almost complete. There is only one bonus round left, and then I will let the song play at full volume. Because there is only one sublevel left. Well, one normal sublevel, anyway. There are other areas that we need to worry about. Oh, we found the... Oh! I didn't find this shop last time. A trap in left tower. Trap tower? A room below the fireplace. Now, we could get this, but we're not going to. And there is a reason why. You remember that platform in that last level? Using the feather, you can go on that platform. That is its only use in the game. No, I don't want the shop. Thank you. Yeah, I think that getting to this shop is a little trickier in the NES version, because you actually have to go up through the ceiling. There's no like door like that. Okay. And now we just need to find... Oh! Found both the Hudson B and the trap door, so I'm not getting the Hudson B. Because I'm terrible at jumping, apparently. Well, let's see if we can chase it down. But I think it's despawned. Yeah. That's gone. Yeah. But we can get... the honeycomb! I think that's it for this level. I just need to find not that door, not buying your wares there, Barnaby. I believe that the exit door is somewhere around here. Hey, there's money. Could be mistaken, of course. Oh, there it is. I knew it was topside somewhere. Ow. Is there anything here? No. You'll notice that now with our current level of bubble, we can actually destroy the lightning bolts. Ooh. We're gonna need this. It's not required, but it's very useful. Actually, if... Yeah, that one's not required. Nothing there. Nothing there. Nothing there. So what's left? Well, not that. What's left is the two towers here. This is a bit tricky. I believe that there is a honeycomb here. Yes! I'm exactly right. Now let's just go right down. I have to worry a little bit here because there are couple of traps in this tower, so really I wasn't entirely kidding when I said trap tower. No! You jerk. Ah. Try not to get hit by the everything here. And now we get to fight a bald eagle. Seeing as I'm Canadian, I have no immediate objection to this. And also, seeing as it's attacking me, well, It's in my right to attack back. Aha! Yes, this is required. Put out fire with water. Eh. Yeah, that is one of the required items to win. If we don't have that, we're not finishing the game. Now let's check out the other tower. Now this one is a bit tricky if you don't know how to get out of it. First of all, try to maintain as much forward firepower as you can, because you never know when something is going to pop up. There's going to be something here. That's always there. That is the one thing that you know is going to pop up. Now you're going to fall down here, and then you're going to go back to a room that looks a lot like the one you were at the beginning, except that you can destroy these blocks. Once you've done that, you need to jump and go where they were, and then drop down to our next boss. Which looks like a particularly unpleasant version of the second boss. Yeah, I really don't know what they're going for as far as a lot of these bosses. But, the important thing is, we can beat them. That'll take us to this little area here. Now there are... Oh, there's a Hudson Bee here. There are some hidden blocks that you can hit. Now even if you can't see them, if you've revealed them, you can still stand on them. Well, looks like we found the princess, guys. Oh no, that's the big princess like they were warning us about. Now we need to defeat this guy. And where the princess was, we now have the crown. Ow. Like, ow, man. Okay, now we need to find the outlet. And for that, I need to navigate a series of invisible blocks. Isn't that great? Okay. There's one right above me here. No! There we go. And we fall down here. Which bumps us out back onto the second floor. Now there's still one sub-level that we haven't seen. I don't remember exactly where it is. Actually? No. Quite certain that it's on... that's accessible specifically from the third floor. That's not it, is it? No. Ow! Yeah, sorry, there's gonna be a little bit of... Okay, how was that supposed to be fair? And that was the other one. Now where is the third one? Is this it? No. Okay. In my process of elimination, it has to be this door, right? Yes. Okay. And this one, actually, it's probably a good thing that I came to this one after the towers. This one is kind of special. Normally, once you've collected money, it's collected forever. However, in this level, you can farm for money. It will always reappear. We could get this, but I'm not gonna worry about it unless I happen to have enough money later. A crown and a cane is needed on fourth floor. We got the crown at least. And there is only one Maharito. That'll come into play later. But what the dirigible does is, if you hold down the jump button, your fall will be slowed. So not super important. It's more convenience feature than anything else. I find it particularly useful on the Nintendo version, but not really so much needed for the Game Boy version. Now that's the exit door up there, but we're actually not going to be using it. I have a reason for that. You'll see. Actually, you know what? I'm actually going to use it. Come on, really? Because now we have more than enough money for the item that we can buy from here. So I'm gonna do that. This will make those invisible blocks visible. Again, mostly a convenience thing, but the tower level that we just saw and the one that's still coming up, spoilers, it'll make those a lot easier if you have that. Get the heart. Just to prove that things respawn. Money, that is. See? Money is all there again. Hudson B. Yes, please. Yes, please. Okay. Okay. So now that we got that thing that lets us put fire out, we can actually kill this guy. Let's see if I can do it from up here. Well, then again, actually, now I realize that it was kind of a moot point anyway, because here is the last music box. Let's enjoy the music. Unfortunately, there are no more bonus rounds, so the only other way to really grind money is in this level. now. The intended way to get out of this level really is this way here. Defeat this fire. Don't have to, but at least then we don't have to worry about it. And there's a passage beneath the fireplace. If we push this, we can go inside the fireplace and fight our next boss. While I slightly get confused with the buttons for a second. Eh! No, don't get hit. Yes! I believe that is 6 of the 7 major bosses. Now we're faced with another one of these rooms. As you can see, all of the blocks are actually appearing now. Now we have to find the princess. This is the room that kind of gives me trouble sometimes. I think she is over here. Yes, there she is. As you've probably guessed by now, that is still not the real princess. Be rather silly if it was at this point. Yeah! Well, so much for gaining health. There we go. And that will give us the cane! Slash scepter, slash whatever you want to call it. Ow! Low on health, I don't like it. Where can we drop down? I could grind for health here, but there are frankly better, safer places to do it. Actually, we're not doing too bad here as far as regaining health. Then I open my big fat mouth. I think there's a drop down. Yes, right here. Oh, come on, really? So now I'm going to go back to the first level. Try to get me some. Get in there, Milon. This is usually a pretty alright place to grind health. It's not very dangerous. And for that matter, I haven't actually discovered the Hudson Bee for this level. I could do that. Have that level, extra level of safety going on for us. Where are you? See, Hudson Bee, I believe, was somewhere either around here or around here in the Nintendo version. Well, if I find it, I find it. If I don't, well, oh well. Right now, we're mainly just looking for health power-ups. There you are! Alright. I got that extra level of protection that we're gonna need for the end game here. If I can even get it done in without actually losing my freaking shield. Ah. I was hoping to get that. Get back in there, Milon. We're not done here. I want to get my full health. And hopefully, you know, big shield too. That would be helpful. I think we're gonna need one more heart for the big shield because we did get hit that one time. Oh, bollocks. Okay. Let's just go. Pretty sure if we had gotten one more heart, we would have got the big shield there, but... Oh, well. Ah! You jerk! I forget which shop that I can buy, full health. No, don't go in there. Also, I'm getting a text. I'm getting several texts. Be quiet, you! There. You can go over here for a few minutes. Okay. Now we can get on with finishing this game. You remember this door here that we can go into before? We can go into it now. What is there? Yet another boss! This time it's a skeleton! And it takes away 3 points of health for every hit. Wow. I'm being bad at this. It's also... we've also lost all of our, umbrellas. Which is fantastic. I'm actually going to retreat. But we did beat the boss, so we don't have to worry about, Oh, I think I remember where the full health is now. Full health is up here. Which does mean that we're gonna have to climb the entire castle again. But it's gonna be cheaper and faster to just get all my health this way. Alright, we only have one thing left to do, which is defeat Maharito to save the princess. And this is pretty much the only not fun part of the game. Because, as Barnaby mentioned previously, there is only one Maharito. But the fact is, Maharito has 3 fake clones. Now let's see. Gonna hope that luck is on my side here and go after this one. Okay. I think there's a glove here. Yes, there is. It was a bit of a smaller hitbox. And enter Maharito himself. This little jerk-faced jerk only takes damage when his arms are outstretched. I'm still gonna fire at him like 8 wild guns because never know when those hits are actually going to register. And we're gonna find out here in a couple of minutes. Not a couple of minutes. A few seconds here. That was the fake. Well, one of the fakes. Let's see if Maharito number one is the true one. First. Okay. I'll get rid of you. You're gonna be a pain in the butt. Come on. I know you're there. Okay, fine. Get over here so I can destroy you. Okay, fine, I'll come down to your level. How do you like that? There. Now we don't have to worry about you. And we get to fight Maharito all over again. If that is your name. Now, once again, getting the sword is not required, but it does make this a little bit easier. And as does getting as many honeycombs as you can. I think I got all of them. Can't be sure, but I think I got all of them. No, this is a fake. Okay. I think what I'm gonna do actually is, see if I can retreat. There we go. I want to make this a one credit clear if I can. Oh no. This is bad. This is very bad. And we're dead. Well, so much for that one credit clear idea. Fortunately, we can continue the game, so not too worried about it. Unfortunately, we start with a meager amount of health. Now let's see if we can spend a minute or two here and get some umbrellas, get some health. I don't think we can get the Hudson Bee again. Yeah, no. As far as I know, I've depleted the Hudson Bees in this game, so... Actually, there might still be one in one of the tower levels. Yeah. Okay, so we are at full umbrella. Which means every umbrella will now be worth health. Slowly. Like, really. Usually these things drop more health than this. Yeah, this is pretty much the less exciting portion of the game. it's still overall a really fun game, and something that you can finish in like an hour and a half. I would be done by now if I had got the right Maharito the first time, or even the second time. You know what? We'll make do with that. Hopefully not get electrocuted on the way up here. What did I just say? Not get electrocuted. Okay. Ah! You jerk! No! Okay, I'm not going into the fight with half health. I'm sorry, I'm just not. All I need is $3. Okay. Now we're back up to over $15. These storms seem to be happening far too often. There. Back up to full health. Ta-da. Yeah. Okay, let's not worry about it. We're almost done. Yeah, up here. Okay. So we know that it's not Maharito number one. We know that it's not Maharito number two. So let's try Maharito number three. Go away, freaking jerk. Thank you. Oh, come on. Sometimes the high jump is not your friend. Okay. Is there a glove here? No. Well, not gonna worry about that. Stick him up, Maharito. Laid into him pretty well there. Another good hit like that, and he's done for. If this is the correct one. Come on. Open up. Open up. Thank you. Fake. Well, that leaves one. And now we're gonna need to climb back down, because if we tried to go from the left side... If you try to go from the left side, we will be stuck with one, one block high, holes. So we would need to be shrunken down for that, and we are not. You know what, I'm not gonna worry about you. I am gonna worry about you. Since you can interfere with the Maharito fight. Well, on the plus side, this is the last one. So it can't not be a fake. It can't not be the real one, rather. Pretty much a battle of attrition at this point. Yes! Well, let's enjoy the ending, shall we? Now, in the NES version, you'd be stuck with this screen. But we get a little more on that this time. And all the elf people, or whatever it is, rejoice as the princess is saved. They all have their instruments, and they're all happy. Victory! And with victory plus princess equals kiss on the cheek. Because of course. You bravely saved Castle Garland! Thank you, Milon! And let's watch the credits roll. This is a pretty short game, as you can see, but I super enjoy it. And I hope that you enjoyed watching this video as we reach the fin, which is the French way of saying the end. But yeah, that's pretty much it for this game. I've showed off as much as I know about it. And, leave your comments, subscribe if you're interested. We got a ton of more stuff like this, some of it quite long and impressive, and others nice little short ROMs like this. Oh, I'm Coolio if you don't know, and I'll see you guys next time.